அஸ்மத் குருபியோ நமகா, அஸ்மத் பரம குருபியோ நமகா, அஸ்மத் சர்வ குருபியோ நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மி நரசிம்ம பரபிரமணே நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே சிவஞ்சடகோப ஸ்ரீ வேதாந்த தேசியரீந்திர மகாதேசிகாய நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மி நரசிம்ம திவ்ய பாதுகா சேவக சிவஞ்சடகோப ஸ்ரீ நாராயண இரீந்திர மகாதேசிகாய நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே சிவஞ்சடகோப ஸ்ரீ ரங்கநாதீந்திர மகாதேசிகாய நமஹா. ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிக கேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய வரியோமே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதா ஹிருதி ஞானானந்தமயம் தேவம் நிர்மலஸ்படிகாகிருதிம் ஆதாரம் சர்வ வித்யானாம் ஹயக்ரீவமுபாஸ்மஹே. ஸ்ரீராகவம் தசரதாத்மஜமப்பிரமேயம் சீதாபதின் ரகுகுலான்வயரத்னதீபம் ஆஜானுபாகும் அரவிந்ததளாய தாக்ஷம் ராமம் நிசாசர விநாசகரம் நமாமி. வைதேகி சகிதம் சுரத்ருமதுலே ஹைமே மகாமண்டபே மத்யே புஷ்பகமாசனே மணிமயே வீராசனே சுஸ்திதம் அக்ரே வாஜயதி பிரபஞ்சனசுதே தத்வம் முனிப்ய பரம் வியாக்யாந்தம் பரதாபி பிரதிவிருதம் ராமம் பஜே ஷியாமளம். கற்பார் ராமபிரானை அல்லால் மற்றும் கற்பரோ புற்பா முதலா புல்லெரும்பாதி ஒன்றின்றியே நற்பாலயோத்தியில் வாழும் சராசரமுற்றவும் நற்பால கொய்த்தனன் நான்முகனார் பெற்ற நாட்டுளே ஜயத்யாசிருத சந்திராச துவாந்த வித்வம் சனோதய பிரபாவான் சீதையா தேவியா பரமவ்யோம பாஸ்கர சகுதேவ பிரபன்னாய தவாஸ்மீதிச்சயாச்சதே அபயம் சர்வபூதேப்யோ ததாம் ஏதத் வ்ரதம் மம. So from today onwards, we're going to be starting a different one, looking at the Itihasa Puranas. Mainly Ramayanam we're going to start that one. And in the Ramayanam, everybody knows this story. What we're going to take a look at that one, what is the real context in which something, the incident is happening. So, Apurva Vishayams in Itihasa Purana. Apurva means which is not, there's no precedent at all, something new, novel, something. So we had to have a different perspective. That doesn't mean what people are told already is wrong. This is a different view to look at them, or probably something is completely new. So that is what we're going to look. So before we start, first all the three, Ramayanam, Mahabharatam and Srimad Bhagavatam. In that one, if you really take a Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Puranam. Shruti is the one, Vedas, that's the highest Pramanam. Smriti is the one what the rishis have kept in their memory and they reproduced that one. So when you take the Shruti, Vedas has got two parts. Which one is the earlier part and the later part? Earlier part is called Purva Bhagam, this is Uttara Bhagam. That is called Karma Gandam, the later is called Jnana Gandam. So Karma Gandam explanation is coming in Smriti. Okay. And Uttara Gandam, what we say Jnana Gandam explanation is coming in Itihasa Puranas. That is why we concentrate more on Shruti and then jumping into Itihasam and Purana. Other so many Smritis are there, Yajnavalkya Smriti, Aridya Smriti, Manusmriti and all of them. But that is the code of living and everything. How we live in this place, how we do this yagam and yagyam and grahastha dharma, all those kinds of things are there. But when we study ragasatra saram and sribhashyam and everything, we are interested only in the second part. That is why we are jumping. And when we see Ramayanam, out of all these three, Ramayanam, Mahabharatam and Puranas. Out of 18 Puranas, 6 of them Satvika Puranas. Out of the 6, Sri Vishnu Puranam is the highest one. And the next one is Srimad Bhagavatam. There is a proverb says Puraneshu cha Vaishnavam. So when it says of all the Puranam Vaishnavam, adhi, Vedeshu Paurusham Suktam, Dharmasatreshu Manavam, Bharate Bhagavad Gita, Puraneshu cha Vaishnavam. Vedeshu Paurusham Suktam. Out of all the Vedas, Purusha Suktam is the most important. Dharmasastreshu Manavam. So many Dharmasastra may be there. Manuniri Sastram, that is the one highest. Bharate Bhagavad Gita. Mahabharatam is so huge, so voluminous. Out of that one, Bhagavad Gita is the most important one. Similarly, of all the Puranas, Sri Vishnu Puranam is very important. So when you are looking at the Ramayana, Sri Vishnu Puranam talks about Ramayana in a very, very small. But before Sri Vishnu Puranam, Valmiki has written. So that is why we go to the Adi Kavyam. So what Valmiki has done? So Ramayana. And Mahabharatam to a lesser extent. Because Mahabharata most of the time that teaches you what you should not be doing. Ramayanam teaches you what you should be doing. And Bhagavatam is mainly about all the avatarams and primarily Krishna avataram, Krishna leelas and everything. So we'll take one by one and see all of them. Sometimes we talk about some of the things that's common, you know already, but we want to emphasize this is what is correct. Sometimes we want to say, just like Agalya Sabha Vimochanam, Sita Agni Pravesham and Bali Vadham, most of them are very controversial. So we look from a different angle, all of them. So let's first start with the, we can have several questions, something like about 100 or 150 questions. We're going to tackle one by one. It may take several weeks to do. The first question, how should we spend the day? We'll start that one and then we go into Ramayana. How you spend the day? There's a one beautiful poet has written, Pradaga Dyudaga Prasange Madhyane Stri Para Sangadaha Ratrau Chora Prasange Sada Kalam Kshipet Buddhaha. That's what he says. Pradaha, in the morning, Dyuda Prasange. Prasange means you are indulging in something, your fondness of something, or you are gratified by doing something. That is called Prasange. Dyuda means gambling, contest. That is called Dyuda. So the way how we should spend the time, in the morning, as soon as you get up, start going into the gambling. We are not talking gambling or playing the stock market or anything. Real gambling. So that is what it says. Afternoon, Madhyane Stri Para Sangadaha. Para Stri Sangadaha. That means other woman encountered, allied with. We always talk and enjoy talking about woman. That is the Madhyane. And night, so if you do this one in the morning and afternoon, where is the money for you to live? So you need to earn. You cannot keep on gambling and talking about women. So what you have to do? The easiest way to make money is steal. So that is what he says, Ratrau Chora Prasange. Night you do this stealing. So this is how you have to spend the time. That is what one poet was saying. What is this, Swami? You start with Ramayanam and Ragasetra Saram and Srivashyam and you start with this one, stealing and talking about women and all of them. No, the real meaning of that one is gambling means the centerpiece of Mahabharatam is gambling. Because of that gambling only, the whole thing has started. We will talk more about Kaikeyi, the character of that one. And we take Bharata, the character of that one. Lakshmana, we take the character of that one. So when you look at all of them, Dharmaputra was very nice, but he still have some handicaps. One of the handicap is basically gambling. So he is so interested in gambling and that is the linchpin for the whole Mahabharatam. That is the linchpin for the war, Yuddham. And that is the linchpin for the Bhagavad Gita. So gambling is the core of that one. That is why Mahabharata you should be listening in the morning. And when it says, Madhyane Parastri Sangadaha, Ramayanam, the whole Ramayanam, it is not the male, it is not the rishis. Female puts a highest, what do you call a credence, highest kind of worshipness to the Lord Rama than anybody else. anywhere talking taking from Thadagai and later on coming into Shabari and then coming into Thara, coming into the Mandodari, Sita, all of them, very, very, including Surpanaka, how they describe, you can make a one-to-one comparison with Vedas and their words. So Ramayanam is full of different women, how they cherish Lord Rama, the way how they cherished, none of the rishis haven't done. So Ramayana is full of women's story. Sirai irindavalin etram. That is what Palilogacharya calls that one. Sirai irindaval. Sirai means jailed. So she is so superior because she was jailed. Why? In that place, she kept at Padivridya Dharma. So that is why she is. And Dudisendravan etram. That is Krishna, Saulabhyam, he went as a messenger. So these two are called Ramayana and Mahabharata, Palilogacharya says on that one. So other women, when we say Sidaya Charidam Mahati, that is why Sidaya Charidam Mahati, Ramayanam, that is what you do in the afternoon. Night, basically what you do is Choraha. There is nobody else other than Lord Krishna who steals everything, including the clothes, including the butter and the yogurt and everything what you got in the home, including our hearts. So that is why probably in a couple of classes we will start the great name Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. So that Maha Mantram is actually coming from Krishna Yajurveda in the Upanishad. And how it is propagated and everything, we'll look into that one, we'll parse that one and see. So when you look at that one, Hare means he's pulling away, he's taking it away. So he is taking all our hearts, Krishna. So when he says, Pradaga Dyuda Prasange Madhyane Sthipara Sangadaha Ratro Chora Prasange Sadakalam Kshipetvadaha, that means morning listen to Mahabharatam, afternoon Ramayanam, in the night Mahabharatam. That is one way of Chaturyam, you know, he has done that poetry. So with that one, that is the first question, this is how we are going to spend all our time. Shouldn't we listen to Srivarsham? Shouldn't we listen to Ragasyatrasaram? You ask, you take Ramayanam, you can overlap one to one with Srivarsham. At the end of this class, I will show some of them. One to one, it is no different. Ramayanam and Srivarsham is no different. That is why when Embarumanar went 18 times and listened to the Ramayanam, because that is the foundation for him to write the Srivarsham. To understand Alvar's Sri Suktis are there. To understand this one is a one to one overlap you can make on that. So, why are we looking at Itihasam and Puranam? First, we had to put the fundamentals. So this may be something you already know. It is not different. Probably in the second class or later half of today, we'll get into the divergence, what things we haven't heard. Okay. The Kaingaryam is three different types. You know, Bhagavad Kaingaryam, Bhagavata Kaingaryam, Acharya Kaingaryam. This is how we spend all our time, either here or in moksha. Wherever you go, only Desa Mattu Visesham. Desa Visesham may be changing, but whatever the action you're doing should be the same. Bhagavad Kaingaryam. First Bhagavad Kaingaryam starts with Nitya Naimitya Karmas. You have to do that one. And then Divya Desha Anubhavam. You go to Divya Desham, Kshetradanam we call, pilgrimage. And help and support the Divya Deshams. So why I'm saying Nitya Naimitya Karma? Because you always know the Kausalya Suprajarama Purva Sandhya Pravartade Uttishta Narasartula Kartavyam Devam Anniham. Hey Rama, get up and do Sandhi. That is what it says. So even Bhagavan showed all of them Nitya Naimitya Karma. Same thing with Krishna also. So the first Kaingaryam, Bhagavat Kaingaryam, he showed. And also Bhagavan showed how he does the Aradhana for the Ranganatha. Sagapatnya Visalakshya Narayana Upagamadhi. So as soon as he was told that his father, oh, you're going to be having the coronation tomorrow. So he goes to Sita and says, please come, let's go and do the Aradhana for our Perumal Ranganatha. That's what he was saying. All this he showed. So that is why I said, the Kaingaryam, what you do, it is not the Acharya takes from some thin air. It is all told in the Itihasa Puranas, and Rama and Krishna displayed and demonstrated. That is why. First Bhagavad Kaingaryam, Bhagavad Kaingaryam. Every single place Krishna did is Bhagavad Kaingaryam. Anywhere from the Gopikas threes to Vidura to Uddhava, all of them. And Lord Rama, what he did, Dasharatha was sitting in his throne. All the rishis would be coming, like the Vishwamitra. But Rama will go to their ashramam and he will go and prostrate to them. So, Bhagavad Kaingaryam and then Acharya Kaingaryam. Acharya Kaingaryam, Bhagavad Kaingaryam means Vedanta Vishayams, you have to write and you have to instruct. Vedanta Vishayams, remember that one. We are all following Vedanta Deshigan, not Veda Vyasar. Vedas, 90%, 95%, 98%, I don't know, most of them are Purva Bhagam, which are basically karmas. We are interested in jnanam. Karma, yes, we have to do because it is mandated. Jnanam, we want to acquire because we want to get out of this samsara. So, Vedanta Vishayams, that is what we are interested in. So, when you say Vedanta Vishayam, instead of talking about Srivashyam and Ragasyatra Saram, why are we talking this Uddhava Gita or Bhagavadam or Ramayana? Because they overlap. What we see in Ramayana, not a story, the Vedanta Vishayams, from that one we are going to be looking. Satsangam, that is very important. When you say Bhagavad Kaingaryam, Satsangam. Rama displayed satsangam, Krishna displayed satsangam in all the places. Rama satsangam included the vanaras. Because that is where they did all the kaingaryam to the Lord. Okay? And then Acharya Kaingaryam. Acharya Kaingaryam, what do? You spread the Acharya's mahimai. You listen to the Acharya's word. Hey Rama, don't think this is Thadaga, is a woman. Take your bow and the arrow, hit her. Rama immediately listened. That's the one probably in the next 2-3 classes we'll see. Did Rama was fair in killing the woman? We'll look into that one. So, spread Acharya's mahimai, listen to their words, and nowadays you have to help the madam and the ashramam for it to cherish. That is all the kaingaryam we do. Always be thankful in your head. Pundi lovapadam. Pongupogal Shatri Vadapadam Shatralavo Munnam Petradarke, Swami Desigan says, keep cherishing in your heart, spread their glories and everything. So all the three what he said, remember that one, those are completely embedded in Ramayana and Mahabharata. That is what we go to. What we learn from Rama is Kaikaryam. What we learn from Krishna is Kaikaryam. And that is what we are doing, Bhagavan is displaying. Lord Sriman Narayana and Moksham is not showing that. Vyuga Vasudevan is not showing that. Even Archavadara Murti is not showing. But only Rama and Krishna are showing. That is the reason why I am picking the Kaingaryam part from them. And that is why we are looking at the Itihasa Puranas. So, Ramayana is, everybody knows this story. At the outermost level, you may not know all the nitty-gritty details, but approximately something you know. But what we are looking is the Abhurva Vishayams only. Let's take first. That is a Ekaslogi Ramayana. Ekaslogi Ramayana means single slogan, Ramayana. Adau Rama Tabovanam Adigamanam Hatva Murgam Kanchanam Vaidegi Haranam Jadayu Maranam Sugriva Sambashanam Vali Nigraham Samudra Dharanam Langaburi Dahanam Paschat Dravana Kumbakarna Hananam Che, edadu, idi Ramayanam. So beautifully as written, Adau Ramo Tabovanan Adigamanam. Once Rama went to the forest with a great smile. Happily went to the forest. Remember the words, happily went to the forest. Hatva Mrigam Kanchanam, golden deer was killed. Vaidegi Haranam, she was abducted. She was kidnapped. Jadayu Maranam, very important. Jadayu is very, very important because Pitru Kadan is very important. How Rama does the final Antima Karyam for Jadayu because of the Pitru Kadan. Dasaradha's Pura Vrithandam based on that. Okay. Sugriva Sambhashanam. Sugriva was engaged so that ஹீ வில் ஹெல்ப் அண்ட் இஸ் வானர சைன்யாஸ் வில் ஹெல்ப் டு ஃபைண்ட் இன் சர்ச் ஆஃப் சீதா. வாலி நிகிரகம், தட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். பகவான் சங்கல்பம் வாஸ் லைக் தேட். ஈ வாஸ் ஃப்ரெண்ட் வித் ராவணா, நத்திங் யூ கேன் டூ. ஸோ தட் இஸ் த ஒன்லி சாய்ஸ் யூ ஹேட். ஸோ வி டாக்ட் இன் ஏ இதில் அபே பிரதான சாரம். ஸோ அதிமானுஷஸ்தவம், தட்ஸ் வாட் கீப்ஸ் ஆன் கம்மிங் இன் தி மைண்ட். தட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ கூரத்தாழ்வன் சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி ரிட்டன் அபவுட் ராமா அண்ட் கிருஷ்ணா சேட், ஏ யூ ஆர் நாட் அ ஹியூமன், யூ ஆர் அ சூப்பர் ஹியூமன். அதிமானுஷஸ்தவம், அதிமானுஷீலிய வித்த வேஷை, அதிவிக்ரம விக்ரம பிரதாபை, அதிலங்கிர சர்வலோக சாமியம், வரையே வைஷவ விபவாவதாரம். தட் இஸ் ஹவ் ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஆன் தட். ஸோ சமுத்திர தரணம், ஓஷன் வாஸ் கிராஸ்ட். லங்காபுரி தகனம், ஸ்ரீலங்கா வாஸ் பர்ன்ட். பஷாத் ராவண கும்பகர்ண ஹனனம் ச, லேட்டர் ராவணா அண்ட் கும்பகர்ணா வாஸ் கில்ட். ஏதது இதி ராமாயணம், தஸ் திஸ் இஸ் தி ராமாயணா ஸ்டோரி. ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ். ஸோ அப்ராக்சிமேட்லி வி நோ வாட் இட் இஸ், பட் வி கோன் டு லுக் நாட் ஃப்ரம் எ ஸ்டோரி வியூ பாயிண்ட். வி லேர்ன்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஸ்ரீ ரகசத்திர சாரம், வி ஹவ் லேர்ன்ட் அ லிட்டில் பிட் ஃப்ரம் திருவாய்மொழி அண்ட் ஆழ்வார்ஸ் பிரபந்தம், வி லேர்ன்ட் அ லிட்டில் பிட் ஃப்ரம் ஸ்ரீபாஷ்யம். நவ் வி புட் டோஸ் கிளாஸஸ் அண்ட் சி வேர் டு ஐ ஃபைண்ட் ஆல் தீஸ் திங்ஸ், அண்ட் தட் இஸ் ஹவ் வி ஹவ் டு லுக். ஸோ தி வே ஹவு தே ஹவ் டன், வி ஆர் கோயிங் பேக் இன் டு தி சர்க்கிள். When you are small, they teach you all of them. So you listen to Ramayana and you say, this is how you have to be. Now after you learned all this Sivashyam and everything, now you are grown up, you have kids and you have grandkids and everything. Now you are teaching them. Now you know why are you teaching. Because you learned the Sivashyam and Ragasyatra Sara. That is the reason. This is not a story like anything. So many stories have come. How come this Ramayana, after such a long time, still people talk about that? Between Ramayana and Mahabharata, Ramayana always stands one step higher. Okay, why keep on people talking about that one? So that is what we are going to look at, that one. Valmiki is the author of that one. It is called Adikavyam. Adikavyam means is the first poetry ever written. Before that, there was not much structure on the people what they write. Even Vedas you take, they are not fully structured, all in a different way. So you have to have a meter, and you have to have the sandhi, and you have a samasam, all those kinds of things he has done, that one. That is why it is called Adikavyam. Because it was the first kavyam he has written, he has made it very, very simple compared to anything else. Valmiki Ramayanam is a very simple one compared to later on what we see in Bhagavadam, or even see Deshika Sri Suktis. So it is close to 500,000 words. 480,000 words are there. 24,000 slokas. 500 sargam. Sargam is chapter. 7 khandas. But still 1/4 the size of Mahabharata. Mahabharatam is 4 times that. So let's compare that one to Iliad and Odyssey. If you take Iliad, Ramayana is 4 times bigger than Iliad. So they call as a great epic. So it is 4 times bigger than that one. Balakandam, Ayodhyakandam, Aranyakandam, Kishkindhakandam, Sundarakandam, Yudhyakandam, Uttarakandam. Everybody knows that one because we have been telling Raghuviragathyam. So everybody knows all of them. So he compacted everything, Swami Desikan, into that one. So all the 7. Out of this one, 6 of them, it is written initially. Uttarakanda seems to be a later edition by Valmiki. And there are some people, controversial people say, no, it is not done by Valmiki. Other people added and everything. We don't want to go into the discussion. So it is added later. So that talk about after Lord Rama came into the coronation, Pattabhishekam and everything, whatever has happened, is the Uttarakandam. We take it that is authentic one because Swami Desikan has included in Raghuviragathyam. So that is why we think it is an authentic, and we go through all of them. Valmiki composed Ramayana. He was a contemporary to Lord Rama. When Lord Rama was living, he was living. When he was in forest, Lord Rama and Valmiki met. Both of them had some dialogues. Okay, so it is not like somebody you write a biography, somebody who has passed 300, 500 years back. No, no, he was living at that time. So what happened is, later on, Valmiki gave shelter. He lived with Rama and everything. And Rama became having the coronation, Pattabhishekam has happened. And Sita was thrown out, exiled. At that time, Valmiki took, when she was in banishment, he took into his ashramam. At that time, she was pregnant. She got the twins, Kusha and Lava. And to them, he is teaching the Ramayana. And then he is holding their hands. And he is going to, when Lord Rama was doing the Ashwamedha Yagam, there these two kids was singing. Kulasekhar Aizhwar so beautifully tells all of them. So we'll do all of them in a later. So that is where the whole Ramayana. And Rama verifies, yes, that is my story. Just similar to Krishna said, nodding for the Sahasranamam. Yes, that is right. When Krishna said, similarly Rama said over here, this is correct. And then he goes and meets Sita, and Sita says, that's our sons. So that is how it happens at the end of that one. So this Valmiki who wrote is long time back in Treta Yugam with Rama lived. So is there any Valmiki temple is there? You ask. I don't know. There is one place in Chennai, Thiruvanmiyur. They called that one Thiru Valmiki Ur. So there is a temple, Valmiki temple there. And they call some thousands of years old, I don't know. So that is only one I know of. Maybe in North India there is something there for Valmiki. But there is no temple for Valmiki on that one. The purpose of Ramayana is basically, what is the ideal one? Remember that. What is the ideal one? Krishnavataram, we will not say that. Krishnavataram, we will not say that one. Krishnavataram, only ideal thing is bhakti. Unflinching bhakti, ideal. If you have that one, everything else you get. But in Ramavatara, every single piece he is showing ideal. Ideal king, ideal son, ideal father, ideal brother, ideal wife, ideal servant, ideal friend. Everything has to be. This is the highest level you should look for, you should strive for that one. So the Ramayanam, the name itself, you take that one, Rama plus Ayana. Ayana, like that's a Tatpurusha Samasam, like what we do in the Ashtakram, Nara Ayana. So similar to that one, Rama, that is the, his name in that Avadharam, Vibhavadharam. Ayana means circulation, the manner, going, moving, that is called Ayana. Dakshinayanam, Uttarayanam, we call that one. Ramayana means movement of Lord Rama. That is what we are talking. This Valmiki has written two other Ramayanams also. Adbhuta Ramayanam, Ananda Ramayanam. Many things are overlapping. But there are unusual stories are there. We don't know the authenticity of that one. But for enjoyment purposes, we will take here and there. For example, Kausalya, I give the punchline now itself. Kausalya is in the same gotram as Dasharatha. Kausalya was abducted by Ravana. And she was put in a basket. And she was put in an island. So that Dasharatha would not get married. He thought whatever Kausalya's son is going to kill him. That's what. Same thing like Kamsa and Vasudeva and Devaki. Krishna avatar. Similar to that one. So we can see a lot of parallels on that. And Rama worshipping the Shivalinga. That is also in that one. Ananda Ramayana. So Adbhuta Ramayana. These are there. But all our acharyas, they don't take it as the authentic one. We are mentioning here for the enjoyment purposes only. So we will stick with Valmiki Ramayana. Here and there we take Kambans we take, or Tulasidas we take that one, because their words are beautiful. How they write and all of them. That is for enjoyment purposes only. Ramavadharam, that is what the title Kamban gave. And they say we call Kambaramayana, finally, Ramavadharam. ராமச்சரித்திரமானஸ், தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் துளசிதாஸ். துளசிதாஸ் ராமாயணம் மெனி பீப்புள் கன்சிடர் தட் இஸ் ஆத்தென்டிக் ஒன் பிகாஸ் ஹி ரோட் இன் அவதி பாஷா. தட் இஸ் வாட் லார்ட் ராமா டாக்ட். ஸோ தெர் இஸ் நோ டிரான்ஸ்லேஷன் எரர். ஸோ தட் இஸ் தி ரீசன் வை தே தாட் தட் இஸ் தி அப்சொல்யூட்லி கிளீன் ஒன். அண்ட் தெலுங்கு, மலையாளம், ஆல் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் லாங்குவேஜஸ் ஆல்சோ ஹாவ் தட் ஒன். ராமாயண டீச்சர்ஸ் ஐ செட் தி அப்ஜெக்டிவ்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி லைவ், ஹவு வி ஷுட் பிஹேவ். இன் மகாபாரதா இட்ஸ் வெரி ஹார்ட் டு ஃபைண்ட். இட்ஸ் இன் தி கன்வலூட்டட் ஆப்போசிட் வே வி ஹேவ் டு கம். திங்ஸ் வாட் வி ஷுட் நாட் பி டூயிங். ஓகே, இட் இஸ் பை டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேட்டிங் எ பாசிட்டிவ் மாடல் இஸ் ஏ வாட் வி ஷுட் ஸ்ட்ரைவ் ஃபார், ஹவு டு வி கண்டக்ட் அவர் செல்ஸ், வாட் சாய்ஸஸ் வி ஹவ் டு மேக் இன் அவர் லைஃப், வாட் திங்ஸ் வி ஹவ் டு ஃபாலோ, அண்ட் வாட் யூ ஷுட் நாட் பி டூயிங். சீதா ஷோட் இன் அசோகவனம் வாட் யூ ஷுட் நாட் பி டூயிங். அண்ட் ராமா எ மேன்ஸ் கான்டாக்ட், வெரி சிம்பிள், திங்க் அபவுட் இட். தசரதா ஹாஸ் காட் ஹண்ட்ரட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தௌசண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஒய்ஃப்ஸ், ராமா ஏகபத்னி பிரதன். ஓகே, ஈவன் இஃப் யுவர் ஃபாதர் இஸ் பேட், யூ கேன் ஸ்டில் பி குட். தட் இஸ் வாட் ராமா ஷோஸ். ஸோ யூ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டில் he listened to the father. He didn't say, hey, you got 100,000 wives, why should I listen to you? Where is your character? Where is your moral? He never asked that one. Remember, these are the things you have to go into that. So Sita also, when he was going for the forest, she said, I will come along with you. Didn't listen. So she said some harsh words. We also know that one. That is one way to make. So these are the things we will go through, that one, why Sita says like that. Nutshell, all with the Gantas we said, let's all get cleaned. We all start from the same base. Balagandam. The first one it starts with, Balagandam, the first Sargam itself. We'll talk about Sri Bhashyam, first four sutras, tell the whole thing. Balagandam, first Sargam, tells the whole thing. Same parallel, you see that one. Balagandam, the boyhood and adolescence of Lord Rama. That's all it talks about, that one, where the Sita Kalyanam and everything is coming. Ayodhya Gandam, it talks about a court of Dasaratha, and then Kaikeyi's boon, she is asking for Varam, and Rama's exile. That is the Ayodhya Gandam. Then Aranya Gandam, that is the book of the forest, Aranyam. First 14 years of Rama, and then the abduction of Sita, all the Panchavadi and everything. What Swami Desiga later on write the Amsas and Desam and all of them, where Sita and Rama, Sita is at some point she says that is one of the most beautiful, very enjoyable period. She cherished that place, and that is what she lived with Rama. And Kishkindya Gandam, that is Rama's stay in Kishkindha, attempt to search for Sita, made a sakyam with Sugriva and Rishimuga Parvadam, that stay, and then killing Vali. That is the Kishkindha Gandam. Then Sundara Gandam. Beautiful. Sundara. Single sloka in the Raghuveera Gatyam. So, Kishkindha Gandam, Sundara Gandam means Anchaneya is Sundaran. And not only that, the slokas are most beautiful compared to anything else. And the landscape and the other thing they describe, that's also Sundaram. So all the things, that's why they call as a Sundara Gandam and everything. And the lyrics and the beauty and everything, the building, they're building the bridge and everything. And then all the Vanaram and Rama goes into Sri Lanka. That is the one in the Sundara Gandam. Then the Yuddha Gandam. Yuddha Gandam is one of the largest one. And so many sargams are how they are fighting with each other. So that is what it's been described. The defeat of the Ravana, recovery of Sita, and return to Ayodhya, and the Pattabhishekam, the coronation. All of them is Yuddha Gandam, end. And then Uttara Gandam. Uttara Gandam is the book of beyond. After that one, what is happening? Rama's life in Ayodhya, after he becomes the real king. Banishment of Sita. Lava Kusha's birth. And Rama and Sita, reconciliation. And Sita, when the earth opens up, goes there. And Lakshmana dies. And then Rama goes back to ascending to the moksha. So all those kinds of things coming, the Uttara Gandam. The Ramayana itself is so beautiful. Ra, Ma, Na, all the four Vedas. Ra, you take is from Rig Veda, Ra. Ma, Sama Veda, Ma. Ya, Yajur Veda. Na, Adarvana Veda. All the four Vedas are put into together. That is why it's called Ramayana. And beautiful in that one is, Ramayana story, what you have learnt everything, is Karmaganda. What you're going to hear from today is in Jnanagandam of Ramayana. So you're going to parse. So where is my Upanishad? You call Veda. Siras means, oh, okay, you take the Upanishad. Last 10%, 5% is Upanishad. No, it is not. Upanishad here and there. Same thing in Tiruvayamuri. Here and there you have to go and find. Out of all the Tiruvayamuri 100, only 20 of them you need. The 80 of them is expansion of that. So where is that 20? 1 through 20 is Jnanagandam, 21 through 100 is a Karmagandam. No, it is not. It is here and there. Parappugayale. So Sivajana Bhushanam, he writes. So it is spread out everywhere. Similarly, in the Ramayanam, we are going to put the glasses, microscope, and see where is the Jnanagandam in that one. What we learn, not the story, but the Upanishad part of that one. Okay. So let me give the first one. Remember this and we'll go back and emphasize more. Balagandam is going to emphasize on Jagat Karanatvam. Ayodhya Gandam, Rakshagatvam. Aranya Gandam, Moksha Pradhanam. Kishkindha Gandam, Kalyana Gunas. And then Sundara Gandam, Samharam. And Yuddha Gandam, Purushottaman. It is what it's going to emphasize. So remember this one. We'll go through all details as we go along. The whole Ramayanam, now when we look from the Ragasyatra Saram viewpoint, when you start the Abhaya Pradhana Saram, Swami Desikan starts with that one, says there are only two things is emphasized in Ramayanam. One, who is the Paratattvam? Paratattva Nirnayam. When you know Paratattvam, that is the Ubheyam. Okay? That is the Purushartham. Then, how to reach him? That is the Ubhayam. That is the Hidam. Tattva, Hida, Purushartham. The reason you are coming and sitting and listening, the reason I am telling, the reason we go into the Acharyas, the reason we do Nitya Karmas, the reason why we are asking the Bhagavan is above us and to bless us, we understand the Tattva. We are all lower. He is the highest one. So, Jivan, Paramatma, Achetanam. Chit, Achit, Ishwaram. Tattva, we know that. Tattva part we understood. Now we come to the Ubhayam and Purushartham. Hidam and Purushartham. Purushartham, Lord Sriman Narayana. Ubhayam is what? He is the one. That is what we are going to see in the Ramayana. Rama is the final Bhagavan. How to reach Rama? He shows himself. He is the one. So the Ubhayam and Phalan is Lord Rama itself. Same thing with Krishna also, we would say the same. Okay. There are two Stuti slogans are there. That about Ramayana Stuti. Vede Vede Pare Pumse Jade Dasaradatmache Veda Prache Dasat Asid Sakshat Ramayanatmana. Vede Vede Pare Pumse Veda Vedyan. Of all the Vedas, like Krishna says very openly in Bhagavad Gita, Vedaisya Sarvehi Ahameva Vidyaha. Ahameva Vidyaha. Ayeva. Krishna loves that word. Remember that. I am the only one. Nobody else. Okay. Mom. Egam. All those things loves that. So, Veda Vedhi. All the Vedam. Pradibhadya Devada. Whether you take a Karma Gandam or Jnana Gandam. It doesn't matter. Jnana Gandam directly tells. Karma Gandam indirectly goes through Agni and it takes the Varaga Paramal and then finally comes Yajna Varaga and comes to Lord Sriman Narayana. All of them goes to him only. Veda Vedyan, when the moksham, when Lord Sriman Narayana is sitting over there, he is cherished, he is being celebrated in all the Vedas, he comes down as Lord Rama. When he comes down as Lord Rama, Vedas also come down as Ramayana. Narayana is Rama. Veda is Ramayana. That is what this sloka basically says. And the way how it is written also, Tadu bhagada samasa sandhi yogam samamaduro banatta vakya baddham raguvara charidam muni pranidam dasasirashchavadam nishamayatvam. All those words, how they are, alliterations, the resonance, how you have to do that one, the words, how they are written. So those we are really enjoying Swami Desikas, slogas and everything, similar to that one. When you look at that one, how the words are there, like the meter has to be there, the words has to be each one, like our teeth. One teeth is large, one small, it doesn't look nice. Arisi pallu mari irukkunumba. So all of them nice, that is how it has to be. And it all same size has to be. And they have to be joined together correctly. And they have to have the meaning. So you have the teeth, but it has to be useful. Similarly here, that's what it says. The alliteration, resonance, the conjunction. So the samasa sandhi yogam, how they are connected and everything. And the appropriate meanings of all of them. All of them are so beautiful in Adikavyam. So that is why Embarumana, Sivashekara, Ramanujar loved this Ramayana. All our Alvars, Prabandham, you take Piriyavachan Pillai Vyakhyanam, 80% of the quotes are coming from Ramayana only. Why? Because Piriyavachan Pillai Acharya, is Acharya, is Acharya, everybody heard from Bhagavat Ramanuja giving the explanations, Vyakhyanam. And he has given everything or only with the Ramayana. So what we learn in the Ramayana there, rhythm, rhyme and rhapsody. Somebody showed it beautifully. So, rhyme, rhythm, rhapsody means it's the bliss. You are blessed with that one when you are hearing that one. So, as Desian says, two things are emphasized. One is Ubhayam, the other one is Ubheyam. It defines the ultimate God. Ultimate God is what we are asking for. Basically, four things. Paratvam, Saulabhyam. You need both of them. When you have the Paratvam, what we are basically asking, sausilyam, saulabhyam and all those kinds of things. And then we are going in a saulabhyam and everything, all the daya and vatsalyam, everything we are asking. All of them put together from the Bhagavan side. From your side, aginchanyam, ananyagadittum. Remember all of them because Ramayana itself is whole Sharanagadi Shastram. Anywhere for starting from Devas, all the way up to the end, Vibhishana Sharanagadi, all of them would be coming. But most of them, they do Sharanagari for other purposes. But our Acharya found out, yes, this Sharanagari is a great weapon. Okay, great weapon. Like Deshika says in one of the Varadaraja Panchasat Sloka, Bhagavan, you got a great weapon called Swatantriyam. I also got an equivalent weapon, holding your feet and doing Sharanagari. So to do that one, we need Akinchanyam Anandegatittum. He need Paratvam and Saulabhyam. So all these four has to be there to make the things to happen. So Sharva Sharanya Paratvam is the final refuge. Nothing is beyond him. When he says, nobody can overrule. In fact, when he says, he cannot even overrule. So that is the first one. Sarvadigara Sharanagadi Rupa Paramahidam. When he gives the moksham, shows his feet, this is the way you have to do, nobody can say anything on that. So both sarvadigara for everyone. So it doesn't matter whether you know Divya Prabandham, whether you know Vedas, whether you are a male, whether you are a female, whether you are a pasu or a pakshi or a manusha, it doesn't matter. Everybody. Sharanagadi Rupa. Sharanagadi Rupa. We are not going for the bhakti marker. So everybody remembers the ties. TACE, when we talked in the Ragastatrasaram, time, intelligence, caste, and energy, none of them. We don't have any of them. Even one of them is good enough. We don't have any of those things. Paramahidam, ultimate one. Nothing else is equivalent to this. So, when Ramayana was written, in one of the Balagandam, in the fourth Sargam, there's a beautiful slogan. It says, Kavyam Ramayanam Krishnam Sitaya Sharidam Mahati Povulatsya Vadamityeva Chakara Charida Vradaha. That's the sloka it says. In that one, that itself Valmiki has shown, I am giving three names for this. Kavyam Ramayanam. The first name he has given is Ramayanam. Krishnam is written. Sidaya Charidam Magadhi. Sidaya Charidam Magadhi. Sidaya Charidam. Sirai Irindavalin Etram. That is what it is. And last one is Paulatsya Mityeva Chagora Chagara Charidavradaha. Paulatsya Vadam. Paulatsya. Pulastya. Paulatsya. Pulastya. We have to take Brahma. Brahmasan Vishrava. Vishravasan Pulastya. Pulastyasan is Ravana. So that is how it comes. Brahmasan Vishrava. Pulastya Ravana Vaishravana. Two people. Ravana means roaring, noise. Ravana means noise. Too much noise. Ravana, roaring. Vaishravana means passive. Ravana, we know, is the villain in our story. Vaishravana is the Guberan. Both of them are born through there. So, Pulastya, son. So, Brahma, Pulastya, Ravana. That is why. So, just like Vasudeva, son, Vasudevan. Similarly, Pulastya is Paulatsya, is called. Paulatsya Vadham. So, three names. Ramayanam, Sita Charitam, and then Ravana Vadham. Okay? Beautiful. When you look at that one, Ramayanam, Rama. Sita Charidam Pirati Ravana Vadam. Beautiful. Perumal, Thaya, and your hurdles to go to moksha. Ravana Vadam. That is all in the single sloka by the name itself, Valmiki has shown on that one. Okay. Again, you take when you take Rama, that is the Paratattvam. Sita Pirati Purushakaratvam. And Ravana is your hurdles. All the reason why you are not going to moksha. So, Bhagavan, you take the Artha Panjagam. All of them would be there into that one. So, we'll talk some of as we go along. So, all these things, when you look at the great poets, even in a single sloka, they try to show all of them inside. Okay. Why Ramayanam is great? That is what we are coming to the question. Ramayanam is great because in our sampradayam, Brahma Sutram is the basic backbone. From the Brahma Sutram is Sri Bhashyam. From the Sri Bhashyam only, we get the Ragasyatra Saram and all of them. Our Visishtadvaita Siddhantam is based on Shariraga Sastram, Shariraga Mimamsa, that is Brahma Sutram. And if you take the Brahma Sutram and Ramayanam, it overlaps so beautifully on that. Ramayanam is so parallel to Brahma Sutra. And I am going to say in concurrence with Sri Bhashyam than Brahma Sutra. Because Brahma Sutra has got different Bhashyams. Shankara Bhashyam, Madhva Bhashyam and Sri Bhashyam. It is the Sri Bhashyam part that's what we are basically interested in. Ramayana is equivalent to Brahma Sutra. When you say that one, the seven khandas are Ramayana, equivalent to four chapters, adhyayams in Brahma Sutra. Here it's seven, here it is four. There, seven khandas, four adhyas, we said. There, 500 sargas are there. Here, 156 adhikaranams. There, 24,000 slogas. Here, 545 sutras. Why it is so different? Because Ramayana does not tell Jnanagandam only. Ramayana is a full Vedam. It is called Brahmagandam and Karmagandam. So we have to pass through. So when you are a small boy and when we listen to Nayandaya, so as a purudubokku, just an entertainment purpose Ramayana, that is a Karmagandam. Now when you're going and looking at the Jnanagandam part, so we're going to extract only the Upanishad parts of from the Ramayana and see how it is going to overlap with that. Okay, let's start. Ramayana starts with a simple question. Valmiki is asking Narada Bhagavan, who is the greatest person living right now? not the past. You should be living right now because we need the proof of that. Okay, that is what he's asking. And you should have the great 16 qualities. Kunvasvin sampradam loge gunavan kashyaviryavan. That is how he starts that sloka. Okay, so Narada answers that one. After two slokas later, he answers, Ishvagu vamsha prabhavo ramo nama janai shrudaham. From the Ishvagu kulam, there is a prabhu. Prabhavo is so magnificent, one guy. That is called Rama. He is the Maharaja. He is the Chakravarti. Ramo namaha. His name is Rama. He is the greatest one. You hear this, I'm going to tell you. He says that. Keep that. Now let's go to the first class of Sivashya. What do he say? What is verse we started with? Adadho brahma jigyasa. Adaha brahma jigyasa. Ada, then. Adaha, therefore. Brahma jigyasa, I want to explore the Brahma. Why you want to explore the Brahman? Because you already did. Then means you have done something. That is karma gandam. Therefore, yes, I went through all of them. I didn't get the answer. Therefore, I am coming here. Okay. So then, therefore, I am trying to explore the Brahman. I am starting to explore the Brahman. That is what it starts. That question, here, Valmiki was asking to the Narada Bhagavan. Who is Valmiki? Valmiki is first, we'll do one day the description of Valmiki. Right now I would say he's a thirudan, he's a thief. He does not have no knowledge compared to us. What we are all thieves. Same thing, he was stealing the property, we are stealing the Atma. Okay? So we are asking the question, Adado Brahma Jigyasa, for us, the Vyasa Bhagavan is writing, Ada Adaha, where is the Brahma? Okay? There he is asking, show me right now, because he is asking Vibhava Vadaram. He has to be standing there with the blood and flesh and moving. We want it here, I had to be convinced that something is making all these things to do. Show me that. That is what we are asking. Even if you bring Rama in front of us, we won't believe. We want something to be everything. All the Andantu, Sagasrani, Kodi, Kodi, Sadanicha. All these Brahmas are there. Above them, there is somebody there. Who is that? We are Anta. We want the proof. So, the first sloka, Valmiki is asking the questions about Rama and answering that one right now. Adado Brahma Jigyasa, I said. Immediately he answers. What is he? Janmat Yasya Yadaha. Answer, you already got it. So there it is, Rama. Here, the one who does the Jagat Karanatvam. Okay? So now you compare what Valmiki and Narada talks and what Sribhashyam talks. So the first sargam, it tells all of them. That is the first four will tell you. Because in the first sargam, Ramayana, you go through that one. Sastra Yoni Twad, Tatu Samanvayat. So all the four of them will come in. That is the palan. What is the palan? Hearing the Ramayanam is the palan. I am giving the Sankshepa Ramayanam. Yes, Kiran. So you see the one-to-one overlap of Sribhashyam with that. Not only that, when later on when we see Purusha Suktam slokas you take, mantra, and then we overlap with the Vishwamitra's word. We take with the Tara's words, everything you overlap, it will be exactly the same. Because it cannot be different. He cannot tell anything different other than because Vedas have taken the form of Ramayana, it has to show the Veda. But unfortunately, many people don't realize. They think Vedas are so great. But Vedas are equivalent because many people cannot tell Vedas. To know Vedas, you have to go through the Adhyayanam. Even if you are a Brahmin, even if you are qualified, unless you go through the rigorous education, you won't know. Even then, you just recite. You don't know the meaning. But Ramayana gives you the meaning, that gives the essence of that. This is how you have to do. You don't realize at all. Okay? There's one story there when there is a daughter-in-law, she got married and coming to the mother-in-law's house. So she was trying to make the dosa. When she was trying to make the dosa, every time she makes that one, it was coming in pieces. It's not coming in full. So she went to mother-in-law and asked, what is that? Oh, I tell you, it's so easy. You put it on the stove, on the kal, on the stone, come and prostrate to me 6 times. And then go and take. So she did that one and saw it was coming out good. So what is the essence of that one? She said, it needs time. That's all it is. So she said in a different way, that's what exactly Ramayana does. All the Vedas, what it is ask you to do, it tells you in a story fashion. See how Sita was, see how Rama was, see how Lakshmana was, see how Anjaneya was, see how Guga was. You should be like that. That is what it tells in a story fashion. If I tell you by Vedas, you won't be listening. So that is why many of the hygienic things in our thing we call Shastra. Oh, Shastra says like that. If I say hygienic, you will be asking all cross question. So when I say Shastra, you don't know. So you're somewhere or other, there's a fear comes. So you try to be obedient for that. So, Adado Brahma Jigyasa, first one, immediately, Janmat Yase Yadaha. Ah, Janmat Yase Yadaha alone will not be enough. Because later on we go, Upayalingha Adhigaranam. Because Bhagavan is a Saguna Brahmam. Saguna Brahma means he has got Kalyana Gunas, Trikalyana Gunas, and infinite Trikalyana Gunas, and nothing of the bad. Okay, so that is what the Ubayalingadigaranam later on we do. So that is similar to that one. Rama, you said, that is not enough. Rama is the Jagat Karanatvam. That is what we said. How it is Jagat Karanatvam, then he asks, then you go through the Srivashyam 4 chapters. That is what here we go through. Either you go through Sankshepa Ramayanam or the whole Ramayanam, all of them. So Saguna Brahmam is the one what we are interested. Because Shankara, when you take, he talks about Nirguna Brahmam. So when you start with Janmat Yasya Yadaha, the one who has created the entire universe, sustains that one and destroys, that is the cause. And everything effect, we see that. That is the Karanam. Everything else is the Kariyam. So, Narayana is the Karanam. Brahma, Shiva, you, me, and this computer, and this table, everything is the Kariyam. He is the seed. Everything else is the manifested product. Same thing in Ramayana. Rama is the core. All the things what you see is the manifested. Because with his sangalpam, is creating all those things like a drama. So just like how Bhagavan creates the earth and everything over here, similarly, in a minute way, we see the Ramayanam over there. Just like what Krishna or Yashoda was asking, open your mouth, she saw the whole world is rotating. They understood that is the Jagat Karanatvam. So here, Rama is conducting himself and showing in the Ramayana all of them. In Brahma Sutra, not even in one place, it says Lord Srimad Narayana. Never mentions Narayana. It says only Brahma. Okay? So, in the Valmiki Ramayana, not even in one place, Rama is the Narayana, it never said. Narayana word comes. Because Rama calls that one. Rama says, Sagapatnya Visalakshya Narayana Ubhagamath, he says, not Ranganada, he says Narayana, because it is coming from moksha. The whole Ranga Vimanam is that coming from the moksha. So Narayana Ubhagamath, that is what it is written. So that is the place it's there. But Rama, he never references him as the Lord, as the final Paratvam. Similar to this one in the Brahmam, it says. But the Uttaraganda, when it comes, Brahma is usually the one who releases all this information. In Uddhava Gita also, Brahma goes to Krishna and he says, Krishna, already Krishna showed, I am the one, everything. But still Brahma comes and says him, Swami, you are 120 years, so time to go back to the moksha. Similarly, in the Uttarakhand and here, that Brahma comes by and says to Rama, you are not Narayana, please go back to your moksha, Sri Vaikuntha. That is what I say. Until then, Rama is never revealed as Narayana, just like Sri Varsham also. So as we go along, we'll do more overlap on this one. That is the first introduction, just to get everybody into. There's not new information on this. Everybody knew, except for some of the overlapping with Sri Varsham. And we had to have a base. Everybody agrees on that one. And now we're going to build from next class onwards. We'll do what is the Ramanama Prabhavam and what is the Purvam Vrittandam of Dasharatha, Purva Vrittandam of Kausalya and Vishwamitra, and how Ramayana and Duhem is connected, how Ramayana and Ashtachara is connected, and Gayatri Mandram in the Ramayana, all other things are there. And then controversial thing also we'll be talking. Okay. Swasti prajabhya paripalayantyam nyayena margena makim magisaha go brahmanebhyo subhamasti nityam loga samasta sugino bhavantu mangalam kosalendraya maganiya gunaptaye chakravarti danujaya sarvabhaumaya mangalam kavidharkika simhaya kalyana gunasalini Srimade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Srimade Nihamanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha.